Last week, on Thursday, 10th August, the NRM Party Electoral Commission Chairperson, Dr. Tang Odoi, called off joint campaigns for the Hoima District Chairperson NRM primaries. This came about when six candidates boycotted joint rallies, citing violence and intimidation by supporters of some candidates.
Like the other day when we were coming from Oraru, one of my agents was attacked, tied, and even by some Kanyamas, which wasn't a good thing to me. Therefore, it caused a lot of fear, and up to now, that agent of mine has never turned up for campaign.
Joseph Kutegeka, the Hoima District NRM election officer, has confirmed that he has received a letter of the revised program for the Hoima District NRM primaries from Dr. Tang Odoi, directing him to extend the voting date.
These candidates first broke off their campaigns due to some unforeseen reasons, but later they resumed just yesterday, and that's the reason why you have extended the period, because of that a short period where they will defeat campaigning.
He has further revealed lack of enough time to prepare that has hindered the process, and some candidates have not yet submitted their revised program since the suspension of the joint campaigns.
Turn-up times was not fast enough, was not good enough, and these candidates, also some of them submitting their programs late, and as of now, some have not submitted their revised programs.
The National Resistance Movement has seven candidates vying for the flag to contest for the Hoima District LC5 seat, and some of the candidates have welcomed the move of extending the voting date.
The extension gives us enough time to prepare and to reach each and every person, to reach the ground, so that each and everyone is aware that we are going to vote through adult suffrage.
So I have no complaint about that. Then regarding the enthusiasm from the electorate, yes, the people are there. Wherever we are going, we are meeting people. Only that in the natural, I was saying, for me, I'm not keen on these rallies.
Jackson Mulindambura, one of the contestants, says much as they have extended the period, they were given very little time to campaign.
I can even say that it was not enough. The days were too short because you are running to fit within the program of the National Electoral Commission of Justice Yabakama. That's why our program has been so stiff. But for one to campaign effectively in this district, you require at least 3 months to have reached every corner of the district.
Meanwhile, Susan Atuhura, who is also contesting for the same seat as an independent candidate, and Moses Aguda, a new candidate, said their main mission of contesting is to address the challenges related to girl child education and to serve the interests of Hoima people.
We want to see more child retention in schools, because currently we've been having a high enrollment in primary school, especially our UPE schools, but the completion rate being very low. Every year we have an 8% school dropout rate for Hoima district.
The Hoima District LC5 seat fell vacant following the death of the former district chairperson, Kadir Karunji, in a motor accident in March this year. Report compiled by Godfrey Mohomuza for the news.